Hello, hello, hello. Welcome back to my channel. My name's Katrina, if you're new here. I am expecting a little girl around the new year. Her due date is January 14th, but who knows? Babies come when babies come, so sometime in January. I am currently standing in the doorway of her nursery that I have finally finished to show you guys, but I figured I would show you the stuff that I just dragged out into the hall because this stuff is not going to actually stay in her room. It's just being stored in her room until she's here because all of these items are going to be used in the living room or the kitchen or just not in her personal space. So to start off with, we have baby gates. This one and this one both make big circles. I'm a little worried about using this one up front because it's really heavy. So I'm not really sure which one we're going to use. We're going to set up both and see how stable they both are locked. The only thing that I really do like about this heavy one is it has a door so I can get in and out without having to take it apart. So again, not sure which one we're going to use, but baby gates for sure because we have dogs. We already use baby gates with our dogs. So just some extras. Some mats to put down in our living room because we have hardwood throughout this whole house. So something softer for her to lay on. And then obviously I'll be putting a blanket down for a while too. Or this Fisher Price toy is going to go in the living room. And it has a mat in there that she can lay on. So big set of toys. That one's probably going to go in the living room. And then some of our other toys I'm sure will end up in there, but I'm going to try and keep somewhat organized. I know that's kind of a joke with a newborn, but I'm attempting. A swing that will be in the living room. So it swings back and forth. It has some stars up at the top. And then there's a safety harness. It's just this piece comes out so you can wash everything. Alright, so now that I've shown you the hall, I'm going to show you a few more items. I just didn't feel like dragging out to show you her room. The boppy, that'll probably be back and forth between the living room and our bedroom. This Mickey Mouse chair, it vibrates and it has some dangly toys for her. I'm thinking that's going to hang out in the kitchen. Maybe for when we're cooking or when we can't actively be holding her, when we're needing to be in the kitchen to strap her in that. And then I have a couple odds and ends tucked in over here. This Bumpo seat, and then a toy just geared for older children. I just didn't feel like they belonged all the way downstairs because I think you can use those relatively soon. That says 6 months, so I'm keeping everything for 6 months and up, or younger, in her room. And now for the real tour, now that I've shown you everything that's not going to be staying in here when she is born. When you first walk in, obviously you can see the door here. You're going to be greeted by the changing table, and the changing table is attached to the crib. On here, I have a wipe warmer, I have plenty of diapers. Newborn diapers are up here, size 1, and there might be a pack of size 2 way back there as well, but I think it's all size 1. These baskets are for things that are going to be used in other parts of the house so that it's just a matter of grabbing it and putting it in to the other rooms. This one's for the kitchen. This I'll just put on the washer to get rid of some stains. But this one is for the kitchen. It's to wash, to dry her bottles, some bottles. What else we got in here? Some towels, some soap. Oh, so this is for the kitchen because she's going to be showering or bathing in our sink for a while. So we've got some soap, some binkies, towels, burp cloths, things to clean the bottles. This goes on this so that everything can dry nicely. That's for my kitchen. This is also part of the kitchen. It's a flower that you set in the sink so that she can get all washed up. And then this little basket is going to be by my bed. I'm going to put some diapers in here as well. I just didn't want to open up the pack until we're a little bit closer so that they're not loose and falling all over the place. But some diapers will go in here. Wipes, birth cloths, bottles, some binkies. And this will just go on my nightstand. Again, more diapers for down here. Wipes on the back of the door. I have a lot of wipes. I know that might seem like a crazy amount. I just really don't want to need to go to the store for a while with the world that we're living in. So I'm having as much as I can get my hands on of items that I know we're going to use, and wipes aren't going to go bad. So I will just use them when we need them. And then we'll just stay on the side of the room. We've got some gray curtains because we kind of did a gray theme in here. I've got a Mickey blanket for her. This was Nick's mom's blanket that he put in here recently. Unfortunately, Amelia is not going to be able to meet this grandma. She just recently passed away. That's why this video was taking me so long to get out. But she does have touches of her grandma throughout, and we are going to have her middle name be her grandmother's middle name, so she'll be connected. Another Mickey blanket. This is my diaper bag that I have some goodies in already. Oops, I didn't even show you it. My diaper bag. Let's see if I can get in here. Jeez. So basically I just have some diaper cream, more binkies, a mat to lay her on for changing. I have some wipes down in there, and just some odds and ends. It's not officially packed by any means, but just as I was sorting, it made it easier for me to throw some stuff in there that I thought we would need. This is a backpack one, so I'll be able to strap it right to myself. And I'm hoping it'll be big enough where I can put my wallet in there as well. This little bag of stuff is just stuff that keeps piling up. Other items that need to go through the wash. Just some more clothes that people have been giving me. Blankets, those kind of things. Towels. Just some stuff I missed or some things that were given to me after I did a big load of Amelia's wash. So this side of the room is her crib and her changing table combo. And we're not putting anything above over here, so this wall is completely done for Miss Amelia. Then if we turn and look at the other wall, we have Amelia's first pins for when she starts going to Disney with us. Obviously, not anytime soon, but baby needs to have her pins. This wall also has another window, so we have the same curtains again. These are her toys. So we have a whole bunch of 0 to 3 months and teething and that kind of stuff in here. And then one of my good friends got her a Figment toy. I realized that stuffed animals are very far for her. She won't be able to use this for quite some time, but Figment is one of my most favorite, and so I just thought it was really cute that she got it for Amelia. Hopefully she'll share the love that I have for her, him. Mickey toy, one of the stackable ones. And then in the toy box is actually not toys. It's clothes that won't fit her for a while. It's 6 months and older. It's not full all the way. It's pretty close, but it's not all the way. So it's like 6 months to like 2 years old, just stuff that I have found that I thought was cute or things that were given to me. So she's got a fair amount of clothes. She'll be all set for quite some time. And then bows, just because we're having a winter baby, bows won't really be a thing we can use for a while. So I kept out the hats and not the bows. I already showed you that little corner over there, that stuff that's not going to stay in here. Her bookshelf, because we are determined to be good parents and read to her each night. or at least several nights a week. I don't want to set myself up for failure and say every single night, but that's my goal. So a lot of these books were actually books that I had as a kid, this middle shelf anyway. We've got some Mickey Mouse ones, some Winnie the Pooh ones. This book was my brother's, learning how to count with animals. And then Hey Arthur over here. These are ones that we'll be reading first. They're geared for more smaller children. The cardboardy ones so that they can throw them around and it won't get too destroyed. And then I have some CDs that I thought would be nice to play in here for her. And then those are just more books that would be counted in this middle section for like a little bit older, but they are just too tall and can't stand up. So they're laying on the bottom shelf there. On top of the bookshelf, we have a Winnie the Pooh piggy bank for her. I've been throwing in some change. Hopefully I will have it filled for her first birthday or something, or as soon as she is realizing what money is. I don't know. Not her first birthday, but as long as it's full when she realizes what money is. Then I have these three little picture frames where I want to put Mickey, so Dad and Amelia, a photo. Minnie, Mom and Amelia with a photo. And then Eeyore with just Amelia. I might even put one of her ultrasound photos in here instead of like a picture when she's first born. And then this bigger frame in the back, I just thought was really cute. My mom just found it and gave it to me. It's a small world after all, and put a photo of her in it. And then above the bookshelf, we have some Winnie the Pooh art. Oh, happy day. Winnie the Pooh, there's always more to discover. And then Winnie the Pooh, you are braver than you believe, stronger than you seem, and smarter than you think. Then if we keep sliding, we're now into her closet area. This is where I'm storing her clothing. So this is newborn to 6 months in here. And they're jam-packed, like it's kind of hard to actually open those drawers right now. So once she starts wearing it, and there's some that's in the laundry, won't be too bad to open, but right now it's very full. Her hats, some socks, and some mittens for her hands. And then this little guy here was something I had in my room growing up. If you can see, it's like a mom and a baby bunny getting a bath. So I just thought that would be cute to put in here. Some diapers, more size one diapers here, just this one piece, size two, that I had a really great coupon on, but I couldn't find a size one, so I got the next size up because eventually she'll be there. A pack and play, which will probably just live in my van for when we go visit family. This is like extra blankets and extra towels for when she's bigger, because these towels are for like bigger kids. They're like the ones with the hoods and stuff, but they're just really cute and I couldn't help myself. And then extra sheets, a little warm winter coat. I have more winter stuff in here for her, warmer like onesies and stuff like that to keep her toasty. More winter coats stuffed in the middle there. This closet's very tiny, so I kind of had to make do with what I could do. And then these are diapers that were given to us for her baby shower. So some size 2, some size 5, and I think I have a couple size 3, like, tucked up in there that you can't see. And then friendship, having buddies you can count on from Lion King. And then this is my last section over here, the last tiny wall. This is my rocker for her and I. Obviously it's got stuff on it, but this is the last little pile of stuff Nick and I have to deal with before she gets here. I believe all of these items are going to be relatively easy for us to put together. So it's a baby monitor, the Owlette monitor. This is a mini sterilizer so I can clean her binkies if she drops them, or her the nipples to her bottle, just extra clean. A bottle warmer and then a sound machine, just because we do live in an apartment house and there's a lot of noise around us for napping during the day. I'm hoping that the sound machine will help her. Then this is a rocker recliner, so it does go back and the feet come up. I have a little trash can for her, for all those smelly diapers. Some more art up on the wall. This is a map of Disney World in Orlando. And then this one just kind of made me think of the show in Disney World, Magic Kingdom, the Philhar Magic. Again, I just thought it was cute, a gray frame, put it up there. Just for some extra decoration. And I forgot to show you what was in these drawers. So we have batteries for the things that require batteries, like the swing and the vibrating chair, and some of the things on that rocker require batteries. So just a lot of those. Some more pacifiers, some binkies. A medicine thing in case she gets sick so it's easier for her to take it. To strap the binky to her. I'm gonna put these in the trash can in hopes that it will help with the smell factor. These for when we're out and about and then we have smelly diapers. And then a baby care kit. And then the rest are all wipes. I mean, bibs. They're all bibs, not wipes. And then some bathroom stuff. So backup bathroom kit and then some blankets.